The evolution of internet speeds, from dial-up to fiber optics. As we stand on the cusp of new technological frontiers, the internet's transformative power continues to reshape our world. In 1991, 2 years after its invention by Tim Berners-Lee, researchers at CERN in Switzerland released the World Wide Web to other institutions and then later that year to the general public. Back then, it had a global average connection speed of just 14.4 kilobits per second. Only a handful of pages could be visited, all with static HTML and limited functionality. The World Wide Web grew rapidly, and more than 10,000 websites got created by year 1994. Online shopping began to emerge with the launch of Amazon on 5th of July 1994. Modem technology quickly advanced, doubling to 28.8 kilobits per second and then to 56 kilobits per second, breaking what had previously been thought to be an upper lie. MIT, for phone line transmissio. NS. Faster connections emerged, and the global average surpassed 1 megabit per second by 2005, around 20 times faster than dial-up internet connect. This became known as broadband and paved the way for new applications such as video streaming. With more improvements in bandwidth allowed websites to incorporate more and more features and user-generated content, leading to the expansion of social media networks and high-definition video. By the early 2010s, most people had a connection of 10 megabit per second, and by the end of the decade, more than half of the world's population had access to the web. As of 2024, the global average is approximately 100 megabit per second and growing by 20% each year. Early adopters and high-end users in technologically advanced nations will gain access to terabit internet speeds in the coming years. This is 1,000 times faster than 1 gigabit per second and a million times faster than 1 megabit per second. It would enable the entire contents of a computer hard drive to be transmitted over the internet in a matter of seconds. This sort of connection has already been demonstrated in laboratory research settings and may be possible for most of the world in the coming decades.